All right, guys, I'm gonna start this vlog out. Got this thing back here at the house. Remember it? The steering wheel's on the wrong side. The left-hand drive S14, if you guys haven't already seen it. I don't actually own this car. My buddy Gobash owns this car, but it could possibly be for sale in the near future, or it may be going off to the States. He's not really sure yet, but keep an eye on that. In other sales situations, unfortunately, as much as I love this turbo setup and this whole hot side of this motor, because it's Japanese and it's OG and all of that, we are moving the kit on. If you want to have a look, I've chucked it on Marketplace. Just look up JZX100 turbo or hot side or something. It's advertised. Hopefully by the time you guys are watching this, it's already been sold. Well, not sold, because I'm not taking it off yet. I'm still going to be on there for another week at least. But the whole hot side off of this car is going. So I'm a little bit sad about that. However, I am super duper pumped on what I do have coming for this car, or what is already here in this case, which I want to show you guys now. All right, so weird looking at the side of the house with sort of nothing in here. However, my tube bender is set up, and it's set up because the reason I haven't vlogged anything the last day or so, I actually set myself a little project with fabrication. And although it's definitely not the best bloody ladder and slide in the world, I built my kids a slide. So Frosty had the slide laying around, it was about to throw it out, so I grabbed it, and then I welded up basically a frame for it, bent up some piping, made ladders, made steps and stuff. Nice little bit of welding, I'm pretty happy with that. So that's one of the things that I went ahead and did instead of car stuff. There's kind of not a lot of car stuff right this second, as far as, you know, there isn't a car in here right now. Everything I have to do on my cars is electrical, and I'm not a big electrical guy, but in this episode, you'll see later, we are going to tackle some of it. I've got a lighting kit to go on the Raptor. I'm also going to go pick up something new for the Raptor today. We are going to start not a build series as such, but there's a lot of things I want to do to the Raptor, and we're just sort of waiting on things to come in. So I'm quite excited about what's coming in for that. We do have some mechanical stuff we can do. I'm going rear radiator on the Suzuki and trans cooler. That stuff's got to go on there. So that's something I really could be getting onto, especially right now when the weather's still hot, but cooled down a little bit from what it was the last couple of days. For all time's sake, I'm going to take you... Oh, wait. If I come around here to show you guys my new manifold. Now, this is what I'm super excited about. RTechperformance.com. Absolute bloody legend. Innovation. Australian, which I'm super duper pumped about. I have already opened this box. I'll show you these Johnnies here in a second. We've got ourselves an RTech manifold. Let me get this out, unwrap it, and have a chat with you guys about it. All right, here we go, guys. RTech manifold. These things are absolutely stunning. So they're actually a cast stainless manifold. I have a few buddies and a few people you guys would know, including Adam LZ, Jimmy Oakes is running this, Summit's running some of this. Like, it really is that good, guys. The ports are just dead smooth. Apparently they're just super easy to fit, which I'm very excited about, because if any of you know anything about JZs, putting manifolds on, especially the Japanese manifolds, they can be an absolute nightmare, and usually are an absolute nightmare. And here the collector is gorgeous. It's not welded, you know what I mean? It's cast. That is super rad. And it's cast stainless as well, so it won't rust or any of that sort of jazz. And I've gone for V-band, V-band on the gate, and V-band on the turbo itself. RTech are going to be supplying me with a rear housing as well, and I'm pretty freaking stoked to announce Garrett have come on board with this as well. So it's going to be a RTech-Garrett combo. See a lot of people running this combo because it bloody works. And then once it's all here, we're going to go down to Frosty and get ourselves a dump pipe, front pipe, and gate pipe all made up. And dude, I cannot wait to have this set up on the car. As much as I love JDM, you know, it's a stainless welded manifold. They crack, they break. Like, that's what they're known for. And, you know, the turbo technology is old. You know, the technology from that turbo, this turbo, is light years different. So I'm super bloody excited about that. But I'm going to get on to doing some work. First thing I'm going to do, I'm getting a sail plane for my car. This is our predominant daily driver, the Raptor. I do drive the JZX a lot, but this is like the main grocery getter and all that. I can't put groceries in the back of that. We still do, but it sucks. We live here in Queensland where you might get a big rainstorm out of nowhere, all of that sort of stuff. And even just it being a hot day, you know what I mean? So, and then on top of that, I don't particularly like the look of these bars. They're ugly. I don't like them. So they've kind of been something I wanted to remove for quite some time. So I'm going to go ahead and start ripping this off and then get ready to pick up a sail plane later today, which when we get there, we'll show you. And then on top of that, like I said, we're going to be fitting the underlights, the rock lights. I have some other bits and pieces coming for this car, hopefully kind of soon, including a change of wheel. So that's pretty exciting. I'm really freaking happy about that. I don't know. Welcome to the vlog. If you haven't already subscribed, definitely subscribe. We've got a lot more amazing content coming. It's kind of 1 o'clock in the afternoon now. I've spent my entire morning, me and Tiana, just going through travel plans and things like that. I think you guys are going to be pretty freaking pumped and pretty freaking excited and everything to see just how much we've got going on. Like, there's a lot of stuff where I know in, like, later this month, there's about 3 weeks where I'm not in Australia for more than 24 hours at a time, and I'm going all the way overseas to a couple of different places. You guys are going to be very surprised, so stay tuned and make sure you subscribe for that. Woohoo, I reversed in without hitting anything. Wow. All right, I'm gonna get started on this. I don't know anyone that needs to know or knows to care about these, but should, in theory, be a reasonably easy job. I think there's just the one bolt here. Like, I'm not bothering keeping any of this because this stuff just like doesn't really sell. A lot of people just rip it straight off the back of their car, and yeah, I think I saw one of them for sale for like $50 the other day, so not really worth holding on to and wasting your time with people on marketplaces and so forth. No way forward. Got so many different size screws, but thanks guys. It's really great. I love tons of different size bolts. Makes everything so much more fun. I'll have to take this old spotlight setup off. I don't intend to reuse it. It's kind of stopped working. I'm gonna end up going with a light bar setup on the back. So I'm going to unplug this from the loom, I believe, and this light bar can disappear with its lights. I mean, these lights can disappear with the light, with the bar, aero bar, whatever you want to call these. Go brake light off. It's not a bad brake light, actually. I may just keep the light itself. Maybe I can put it on the Suzuki or something. That could be kind of cool. I'll hold on to that, and I believe this stuff will just thread back through. actually really hard to like pick up and move without. Yep. All right. So I don't want to break anything, including myself. Oh, I'm in a shit spot. Oh. All right. Finished. Obviously the truck's dirty. Let's leave a couple little marks, I guess, from factory just on top there. But overall, I think you'll agree, this is a better look than having the bars. Honestly, in a perfect world, I think I really like those hard covers you get that you can stand on and all that. They're super strong. I don't think I'll get one of those though. They're really expensive. The thing I'm going to pick up later today is very cheap and will allow me to lock the back. Because one of the things as well lately, I've been taking Boston riding a bunch now, and like when we go somewhere to eat or drink or anything like that, we've got the bikes in the back. And right now, obviously, we strap them down and everything, but still kind of easy to steal. Where once we've got this cover and we can lock it, means when I take Boston riding, we can go and get some sushi or whatever, our bikes will be locked up and no one will be able to touch them. So yeah, really excited for some of the moves that are coming for the Raptor. I freaking love my ATI wheels. I don't think I'm going to get rid of them. I actually think I'm going to keep them because these are a beadlock wheel, a true beadlock wheel. I think the other set I'm getting are more like lightweight and better for daily driving. Because believe it or not, with the Raptor suspension, it really suffers with the heavy wheels because they're a true beadlock. They're big, they're solid, they're strong, and they're a really big tire. Probably too big. When I say too big, I freaking love it. But for daily driving, I could definitely do with going down an inch. So these are actually a touch bigger than a 35. I want to go back down to like a 34 and make the car a little bit better for daily driving. And with a lighter wheel, it should make the suspension work a lot better as well. Because I do notice at the moment, so on the beach and things like that, when you do hit a bump, you know, a bigger, heavier wheel is more rolling mass. Call it inertia. It makes up for a lot with your suspension stuff. So like wheels, the weight of wheels is kind of really important. Not kind of, it's super important for how well your suspension works. Obviously, the wheels that come on the Raptor stock are a lot lighter than a beadlock, than a big, strong beadlock wheel. I can't say enough good stuff about the ATI wheels. They have been phenomenal. And like I said, I won't be getting rid of them. I'll just be putting them to the side, and they may even find their way onto the Suzuki with some treps on it. Maybe. It's on my mind. I kind of want to do it. I had spoken to the eight guys at ATI before about possibly, you know, doing a set with a more aggressive offset. Which they now do, but I still need more aggressive offset again. However, I could just run these with more spaces, you know what I mean? So we may look into that. But anyway, it's going to be fun getting to work on making this, you know, a more permanent fixture. You know, I've been kind of neglecting to do anything to it because this was the replacement one and I had the issues with the other one. This car has been running phenomenally. Does go in for a service tomorrow. I'm going to chat to him about some of this. There's actual fading in the window part here, the rubber. Everybody else has been getting them replaced by Ford, so I'm going to do the same. Other than a squeak in the driver's seat, this car has been absolutely perfect this time around, so I'm very, very happy with that. So, all right, I'm going to pick up the kids from school. Just realized I got some time before I pick up the kids. I'm going to take you guys for a quick drive in this thing. I'm going to put a mic in the engine bay to try to hear some of those sweet turbo sounds. See how it turns out. Hopefully it sounds good. All right, I just remembered I finally got my third gauge. So I'm going to go ahead and chuck that in. The reason it wasn't here is when I got the gauges, the light didn't work. Tim, who I got the gauges off, was awesome. He took it back with him and got it handled for me. So appreciate that. Cannot wait to see this in a second. I'll just quickly chuck it in. All right, pretty freaking stoked. New gauge is working perfect. I guess we'll go from here. Go for a little
Well, we'll go for a little drive. Just want to hear the turbo again. Stoked that gauge is working. I stalled it. No! Right, third time's a charm. Put my seatbelt on. Hope I don't freaking stall it this time. I don't normally drive in the daylight without sunglasses, but I forgot them. So I really don't know what this is going to end up sounding like from the point of view of the actual the noise that the mic's going to pick up. Hoping it picks it up well. So JDM in this car. I've even got high chews. Oh man, I'm so pumped to have all the gauges. It looks so good. High chews aren't as good when you leave them in a hot car, hot dip. Hot dip for the heat. Oh, the Defi's and the... There's a Defi, Nardi, Apexi Parasite, and Brideseed combo is too good. Such a nice sounding car, makes me so happy. All right, that's got me super happy with the JZX. Having all the gauges in there. I've just worked out that my dash cam is sort of doing a battery drain. If I turn it off when I get out of the car, it's fine. It's only meant to draw 5 volts. I feel like it's drawing more voltage, or maybe I've got it set up wrong so the screen ends up on the whole time and that's what drains the battery. But if I leave my dash cam on, which is good because when it's parked, it's still working, my battery goes flat. So yeah, I need to turn it off every time I get out of the car. Just kind of annoying. Voila! A new thing, sailplane. They all come in that color no matter what color your car is. So, I don't know. I have to get you guys a clip of this from the outside later in this video so I can show it up the top. Anyway, these bits I'm gonna need to do something with, maybe paint them black or something because they're too bright. Everything that was this color, everything that was that color on this car I sort of got rid of. So it was like a big bash plate and everything under the front here. This part here was all that alloy color and I don't know, I didn't like it. But we're gonna go ahead and get on to putting the rest of this on first and then getting onto these rock lights. There are a few little bits and pieces we don't 100% know where they go here. So we're gonna like suss it out. All right. Can't really show you, we got too excited and started getting onto other things, but that part is done. That's all on, secure, actually works just like I hoped it would. Now we are at the front of the car now working on our rock light setup. So I've got all the lights here, got 6 lights that'll go under the front of the car, and we're just under here sort of working out a spot. So I think we're gonna put one. I think we're gonna put one right here, another one right here, and then another one down
under here
where Hayden is down there further. So we'll be running 6 lights on the front and then 4 lights at the back. And the whole idea with these is to light up the ground for when you're off-roading so you can see where your wheels are going. Very similar to a LED setup you'd run on our drift cars and on your Jap cars.
On the hot boy car over on your,
there. Yeah, exactly. but it's designed, you know, they're rock lights. They're designed for seeing rocks and stuff like that. So basically...
Seeing the curb at the KFC drive-thru is what they'll be
useful. It's an excuse to run RGB neon-style things on your four-wheel drive. And I'm going to do it because I love it. I think it's sick. So we're going to go ahead and start working on it.
So, progress shot. We've got one here
Actually, I didn't really think about that with that being the tow hook. Oh, send it. One. Oop, there we go. Almost looks factory in there. Then another one. Just there. Now we're just going to wire everything. So the instructions say get as close to the battery as you can. So, there you are. So we're just going to run the wires up to the battery, and then I'm going to cable time there and see what time it is, because I have to work tomorrow. So we'll see what we can get away with tonight.
What do we got going on here?
Mate, we've done a thing. You wouldn't read about it.
Nah.
I'm a bloody one of them Forby guys that has all the flashing lights and stuff. Trying to work out how to make the lights work, which is fun. Yeah.
Let there be light, though.
Let there be light. No. All right, guys. Ultimate hot boy 4x4 now. I'm actually so pumped on this. You have no idea.
Check this out. I have big glowy boys. Hayden had to get his going as well.
Had to show off, you know.
He's trying to show me up.
Oh, hold on.
You can set them to, he was setting them to the same color as mine before. There we go. How's that? Mashy, mashy. I need that light to turn off, but when that light turns off, it really does pop even harder.
That looks insane on camera.
Pardon?
That looks insane on that.
Yeah, it looks decent for the GoPro. But
if you can see me, the main thing is we've got 6 lights at the front, 4 lights at the back, and it actually does exactly what I need it to. Like, literally when I'm off-road with this now, I'll be able to see absolutely everything I need to see underneath the car. And I think that's just super rad. And what a day. I've actually accomplished a ton of stuff today. Massive thanks to Hayden for giving me a chop out with the lights. It's what, 11 o'clock at night?
Yeah, close enough too. Work tomorrow is gonna be great.
So yeah, another 11 at night. We've been hard out on this since, probably like 7 really.
Yeah, it wasn't too late.
Yeah, probably 6:37. So we've given it a decent chop. And I don't know, I can't be happier, guys. I don't have any link or anything. I just bought these off, I think, eBay or Amazon or something. I'll try and find the link for you if you want. Let me know if you want it and I'll pop it up there. But
we did the roller.
Really, really friggin' happy. Obviously, the roller shutter on the back now fully lockable, which I'm very happy about. The lights underneath, like, I did stuff on the JZX today. Very good day. You know what? Stay positive, guys. Jump into the store. Grab yourself one of the Stay Positive shirts. Can I personally recommend the C35 Laurel shirt? Is so freaking good. And it's being slept on, I'm telling you. It is one of the coolest shirts we do. Jump on there, check it out. And I only just remembered that we do kids shirts still in the JZX 100 stuff. And then we've got singlets and stuff like that as well. So definitely, please go and check it out. LukeFink.com. And we'll see you guys in the next vlog.